Stewart, welcome back inside our Proactive Newsroom. And joining me now is Elmer Stewart, the CEO of Copper Fox Metals. And Elmer, welcome back. It's great to see you again. How are you?
Good, Steve. Good to see you again.
Yeah, so the company's put out a news release sort of highlighting what happened in Q4, but really also talking about 2022 as a whole. And it was a very, very busy year for your company, and it really set up what's to take place this year. So, Elmer, just give me some thoughts on 2022. There was a lot of work and a lot of different projects.
Essentially, what we did in 2022, Copper Fox was focusing on its advanced stage Van Dyke project in Arizona, and that's an in-situ copper recovery project. We also wanted to do some work to move some of the other projects along, which is essentially our strategy, do a little bit of work, move each one of those projects along each year. A little slower than we thought it was going to be at Van Dyke, and that's primarily because of getting access to services. But on the joint venture with Tech Resources, they completed the metallurgical program. We got some really interesting higher grade zones of mineralization at or near surface. And that's within the first 5-year pit. We can't quantify the meaning of these higher grade intervals. But the thing is, we did get a good sampling of grades across the deposit, which now allows the metallurgical test work to go forward. And as you may recall, the metallurgical test work was one of the project enhancements that was identified in the 2021 PEA that it could have a potential of surfacing additional value at Shaft Creek.
And so now you move into this year, and you mentioned Van Dyke, and I want to talk about that one specifically because there was a lot of work that set you up for this year. So what do you hope to do there this year?
Well, now that we've cleared the biological assessments, essentially said that the evaluation said no plants, no species, no habitat. So what we wanted to do is we wanted to clear all the potential issues that could affect your ongoing field activities going forward. And we did that in 2022. And that took a little longer than we expected too. The good news was the results were, you can go ahead. There are no species, no habitat there. And as far as the noise, not going to be an issue. Access traffic, not going to be an issue. And all the other things that you have to look at when you're assessing going forward, especially when you have an advanced stage project like Van Dyke. So we got that done. And so the first thing was we wanted to re-enter some drill holes, some historical drill holes. And if we're successful in doing that, and the results are still pending, we're in the process of that. But the upshot of doing that was, if we are successful in doing that, it's going to save the company several million dollars of drilling costs. And like I said, if we're successful, it'll save us $7 million of drilling costs because we will have to drill the holes. If we're unsuccessful, well, then we know what we have to do. And so we're now moving through that right now, and we're currently kicking around some ideas with our technical consultants as to what would be the next steps forward, because these projects, they look very simple, but primarily it's trying to figure out the chemistry of them and the connectivity. And there's a lot of stuff going on here, but the key is they're very valuable, low impact on the environment, low water consumption. They've got a lot of great criteria going forward.
What about some of the other projects? What are you looking at to do in 2023, Elmer?
Well, and we did an airborne survey of Mineral Mountain and Sombrero Butte. And in hindsight, probably should have done that several years ago, but I mean, it's not a perfect world. But the idea is what those surveys identified us clearly positioned and actually brought together all the information we've been collecting over the years into a very identifiable porphyry copper target. So essentially what it did was improved our certainty substantially and has clearly identified those parts of the property where you want to focus your exploration on and those parts of the property that there's probably little or no reason to spend any more money on. That's not to say you drop the ground, but you're able to refocus. And that's the whole thing about exploration. You start big, your focus comes small. But here's what I really like about 2022. Despite the fact we didn't get a drilling permit at Eagle Head, which is a big porphyry copper system in Northern British Columbia, it's located in the Quinella Train. To me, it's probably been a forgotten porphyry copper style mineralization that people just forgot about because of location. Mm-hmm. But the work we did in 2021 and 2022, and we're working on bringing this data to the market, clearly indicates that we believe we're sitting on a fairly substantial porphyry copper system. We do believe there are four copper deposits on the project. outside the footprint or the big area, which is about 8 kilometers by 3 kilometers, there's other styles of porphyry copper mineralization on there. And the work we're doing right now, when we announce the results of that work, I think it's going to turn a few heads in the mineral exploration business in British Columbia.
Okay. And are you also always on the hunt for joint venture partners as well for anything else? Are you settled where you are right now for this year?
No, we're always open for discussions.
Yeah.
But we're not going to stop our projects from moving them along the exploration chain, primarily because value is built up in finding copper in the ground. Not only copper, but the key for us is being able to identify a resource estimate on a project. That's a major milestone.
Yeah.
We already have resource estimates at Chef Creek, Van Dyke, and probably the closest one you can see right now because of the 120 mineralized holes is the Eaglehead. But we're always open, but we're also looking for a fair value for the risk we've taken and how much we've de-risked our properties.
Yeah, it makes a lot of sense. Elmer, congratulations on the successes in 2022. And we look forward to many more discussions in 2023.
Great. Thanks, Steve.
All right. Elmer Stewart, the CEO of Copper Fox Metals.